Well, Dell, here we are.
We're here again.
Historic Ryman Auditorium. Setting up for the Bluegrass Nights at the Ryman back here. I get to open the show for you and the boys, and really excited about that.
We couldn't have had a better opener, I'll tell
you. Hey, well,
I'm Are you sure I'm not opening for you?
Oh, I'm very, very sure. The thought of getting to come to this venue, which I know is a very special place to you and a special place to everybody here in Nashville, just thought we would get together and talk a little bit, and maybe you could share some stories with us. I know before we started filming, you were talking about the very first time you came to Nashville, you came to the Ryman, so maybe you can
tell us about that. And I guess it was 1956 when I figured it could have been 55, but we came here and sit in the balcony up here and watch the whole Grand Ole Opry show, you know.
Well, you said when you came here, it was with your mom and your dad, and you were a teenager, right?
First time, yeah. Somebody figured out I would have been 16, 17.
Wow. Did you ever dream when you were sitting there that you'd someday be headlining your own show?
No, never did. Never even dreamed of being a part of Bill Monroe's band.
You said you were disappointed because Bill wasn't there that night. So.
I wanted to see Bill Monroe, you know, and Earl Scruggs.
So I guess the first time you actually ended up playing that stage was with Bill?
That's right.
Yeah.
If it's all right to point, there was a little ramp that came down from this side down to the backstage there. And we were talking a while ago. The seats, they came around over top of the backstage then, and so people could watch what was going on behind the curtain at all times.
Yeah. You know,
a lot of folks would rather be back there than they would up here.
And that was supposedly the cheap seats.
That was the cheap seats, yeah.
Hey, good cheap seats.
Yeah, good cheap seats. That's right.
Here in the Bluegrass Room backstage at the Ryman.
The new Bluegrass Room.
Yeah, they just did a big renovation of the whole backstage and added a cafe, Cafe Lula, I think it's called.
Wow.
I had a sandwich over there right before coming over here.
So I got to try that.
Chicken salad sandwich. Uh-huh. Pretty good. You like chicken salad?
I like chicken salad. I like any salad.
Well, me too.
Yeah.
Me too. So we're here in the Bluegrass Room, very fitting, because we got Bill Monroe over here on the wall. And who's that guy? Who's that guy?
I don't know him, but I know this guy.
We got Ricky Skaggs, Allison Krauss,
Allison,
Dell right. McCoury. That pretty well sums it up. So this is your first time actually being back here in the Bluegrass Room. Since
it is.
Yes.
I've been in this room before, but now it's designated. The Bluegrass Room.
The Bluegrass Room. Mm-hmm. So this will probably be where you'll be.
And Bluegrass
you come is play the
on
Opry.
The monitor there and everything.
Yeah. You sit back here over there, see the stage on the monitor. And
that's right.
Know when it's time to go on.
Yeah, and there is the original Bluegrass band, isn't it?
That's right. Right.
It's right there. If you come to this room, you'll see that original Bluegrass band.
Maybe if they
to
come
you
take
by
a tour of the Ryman.
Purina Chow.
Purina Chow, that's right. It says
that's
that over there on
exactly
the picture.
Exactly right.
That is right.
Chubby Wise, Bill Monroe, Lester Flatt, Earl Scruggs, and Cedric. I can't see the bass player, but.
Good eye. Well, Dale, it's been real fun hanging out with you today.
Yes.
We'll get to play the Bluegrass Nights at the Ryman Show, and of course, we want to invite everybody that's watching this to come see us.
Looking forward to
it. A few tickets still available, I believe.
Right,
so,
yeah.
July 2nd.
Best place in the world to come and see music.
I agree.
The Ryman Auditorium. Bye.
far. Tell me you don't mean goodbye. So that's goodbye.
Goodbye.